Okay, my posts are in. I filled in the space between the concrete and level with the driveway with some gravel, as did I on this side. And I did this to these ones as well. There wasn't as much between the concrete and the dirt, so I figured putting dirt and grass on there probably wouldn't do any good. So I just filled them up with a little bit of gravel. It'll look half decent, and the lawn's all manicured around it. Now let me show you. I gotta keep my camera kind of pointed down because it's raining, but let me show you what I did wrong so you won't do it wrong. See, when you look down, see this one pole here? Come on. God, this beam sucks. There we go. See how it's just off a little bit? Actually, it's not off as much as it looks like in the camera, but basically what I did, I had my line strung up, and that was the first one I did, and it was dark, and I was trying to get it all done so I could get it on camera because it was going to rain the next day, blah, blah, blah. But what I ended up doing is putting this post on that side of the line, and all the other posts were on this side of the line. So this one's off by one post. It's not going to be a big deal. I'm not doing this for aesthetics or anything like that. It's just to keep my dog in, but just to teach you guys a lesson to do what I didn't. Make sure all your posts are on one side of the line or the other side of the line. This way they'll all be even. Anyway, my camera's getting soaked. So is my doggy. Hello. Pretty soon you won't have to have that noose around your neck, eh? Do you like that idea? No noose around your neck. Oh. You don't even care about me, you're just sniffing around. Sniff, sniff, sniff. Anyway, pretty soon my dog won't be on a noose anymore. Well, a little bit of time has gone by since I set them posts. What I did next was I made sure I had the tension bars on first. Got my top bar and rail applied. And it's actually on the fence. I've got three for my tensioners, and I got one for my bottom wire. You can see it there. There's two down there. Two up here. I'll run a thought I had bottom wire, but I don't. Next thing I would do would run bottom wire from that bottom rail all the way across. Where I have pieces set up here. One for the bottom wire, three for the tensioners. Got this set. Had to kind of do a little redneck spacer thing, because this was for a bigger post. So I put two inserts in it. Gets it pretty solid. I got a little piece of fence that I'll be tying into my neighbor's fence with later. So I'll run the bottom wire there. And right now I've just got this temporary. I just got it held in by a couple bottom rails just to keep it from moving around. But I thought that I had a 4-foot fence, when in actual reality it's about a 3.5-foot fence or something. So these top rails I'm going to make adjustable at the once I stretch the fence. I'll know how much lower to set this so it'll be even with the fence. Then I'll set that down, cut the top of the posts to match what the height will be for the top rail. And because I screwed up on this post, I did this one on that side of the line, and all the rest I did on that side of the line. So this one's a little offset. So what I'm going to do is going to get a top post I guess they're called rail, I don't know what they're called, top post holders. It's like a little round bit that caps the post off, and then your rail goes through it, something like that, but it's a post cap. I'm going to get one offset this way, or actually this one I'll have offset this way, and then on that one, I'll get it to offset that away, and then it'll kind of line itself up fairly good. So, no doing any of this until I get that bottom wire, and then I'll be able to stretch the fence. Hey, when people use my driveway, turn around in. Then this side, I'm going to run a bit of a top post across. It's really jury-rigged kind of thing. I run it across and past this post, which is a little sloppy. But what can I do? I ran out of posts and I don't have any money, so I got to make do with what I got. So I'll put a piece of top post across, bottom wire across, and then whatever fencing I have left over, I'll fill in the gap. This is about 5 feet. So hopefully I'll have about 5 feet left over from there, and then all I gotta do is save up some money for some gate posts. They're about $22 a piece. Slowly but surely, this gate will get complete, and my dog could be without a noose soon enough. Things never happen quick around this house, I'll tell you that right now.